So good morning. I'm Gina Valentine. I'm the Bureau Chief here for Aging and Disabilities. And thank you all for joining us today to celebrate 50 years of the Bureau of Aging and Disabilities, Aging Timelessly. We're here today to celebrate the services the Bureau provides to the Carroll County community, the hard work and dedication of our staff, and the ever so effective and collaborative relationships that we have with so many of our community partners, many of whom are represented here today. We have a lot of great things in store for you today, and that information will be shared later on. But now I'd like to introduce our special guests that we have here this morning. First, Commissioner Ed Rothstein.
Hello.
Commissioner Steve Wance. Celine Steckel, our Director of Department of Citizen Services. And then representing Senator Ben Cardin's office, Jessica Cook. And representing Chris Van Hollen's office, Nan Mann. On behalf of Secretary Owings with Maryland Department of Veterans Affairs, Elaine May Stem. On behalf of State's Attorney Alan Culver, Dean Brewer. Jim McCarron, who is the chair of our Commission on Aging and Disabilities. And then finally, our friends at AARP Maryland, Hank Greenberg, who is the state director. Jennifer Holtz, the associate state director of outreach. And Nancy Carr, the associate state director of communications. So just to provide you with a little bit of history and background of the Bureau, it was established in 1972 as the Commission on Aging, which was housed within the local health department. The Commission on Aging began with one staff person, their director, and I'm honored that this person is here with us today. Please join me in welcoming Fran Mickle. Fran, if you could raise your hand for us. So exciting to have Fran with us today. I'm so happy she could be here. And I thank her daughter, Mari, for reaching out to me and for bringing her today. One of the first things that Fran did was she organized and consulted with an advisory group to explore the needs of our older adult population. In 1972, the first senior center was opened in the basement of a home on Washington Road that was formerly Miller's Restaurant. Older adults came to the center for a program called Eating Together, Socialization, Playing Cards, Penny Ante, and Piano Playing with sing-alongs. One of Fran's favorite memories is when they acquired the first van for what was called the Senior Overland Services, which was a transportation program. Fran shared that this was one of her favorite memories, and they were all so excited that they went out and they kicked the wheels of the van. Fran was also involved with planning Timber Ridge and was there to help turn the first shovel of dirt as the construction began. Fran enjoyed her work, and there were so many people that she met along the way that she continues to have relationships with today. Fran, thank you for your hard work and dedication that helped to mold the Bureau into what it is today. So in 1980, the Commission on Aging became the Bureau of Aging and then was housed within Carroll County government. We've achieved so many accomplishments over the years, but to name a few, historically, the Bureau of Aging is known for serving the older adult population. But in 2009, we became an Aging and Disability Resource Center, serving, in addition to older adults, individuals with disabilities. And we did that in partnership with the Freedom Center, which is our local center for independent living. Another accomplishment in 2013, with the support of our Board of Carroll County Commissioners, was the implementation of the Veteran Services Program of Carroll County. To date, we now employ three part-time Veteran Services officers who are trained and accredited by Maryland Department of Aging. And with the assistance of the Collart Foundation, we obtained a grant that enabled us to hire a part-time case manager to provide case management services to veterans who have needs that fall outside of what the VA system can provide. The grant also enables us to provide support to homeless veterans, to divert veterans from homelessness, and to provide for other emergency needs that they may have. Since the implementation of the program, our Veteran Services officers have assisted veterans and their spouses and dependents with claiming and recouping over $45 million in pension and compensation claims. $45 million. That is a huge accomplishment. So, yeah, thank you. Thank you. And our Veteran Services program continues to be a model for the rest of the state today. We continue to focus on our efforts to improve service delivery to older adults and individuals with disabilities and veterans and those who care for them. There will be an announcement a little later on about the partnership that we have with AARP Maryland, which demonstrates our commitment to continuing to evolve to support and meet the needs of the Carroll County community. The last 2 years presented us with many challenges, but our staff adapted, learned how to offer continued services, took on new assignments, and learned how to do things differently, and they persevered. I can't tell you how dedicated and hardworking our staff are, and their work over the last 2 years absolutely proves that. I'd like to thank all of our staff for what it is that they did to prepare for the events of today that you were all here to enjoy. And you all continue to amaze me, and I'm so proud of everything that you do. So thank you. I'd also like to thank our Bureau of Facilities ground staff for all the work that they did to beautify our buildings and our grounds. They've worked really hard over the last I don't know how many months, and their work is definitely recognized and appreciated. So thank you to Chris Vernal and Eric Zepp and their team for all of your hard work. And lastly, before I introduce our first speaker, of course, I want to thank our Board of Carroll County Commissioners for their continued support of all the services we provide, the hard work of our staff, and the programs and services to the community. So thank you. So first, I'd like to call up Commissioner Ed Rothstein.
Okay, thank you, Gina, very much. And Gina and Celine and the entire team know I use the term rock stars often. Now, the challenge when I use rock stars in referring to them, it means there's typically more work for them to do because they are absolutely rock stars. So if we can, give them another round of applause. Fran, you must be very proud and humbled by how this has come about. And if you can visualize an oil drop in a pond, and it starts, and then it all of a sudden starts spreading. So from 1972, you dropped that piece of oil in the pond and started a program. And to think that we've gone to $45 million saved for our veterans from 1972 to just where we've gone is amazing. We are absolutely a model for our state. You know, Greg, the work that you do in supporting us, I cannot say, you know, thank you enough. And from the entire team, I'm proud to participate on the aging disabilities, and I'm proud to participate on the Veterans Advisory Council. It's not about leadership. It's about having the ability to listen to the community, learn from them, and then really most of all, leading together with all of you. We make a difference. We are absolutely a model in the state. Nobody knows Carroll County better than Carroll Countyans, and we just do it right. So just again, in closing, I just want to say thank you to all of you for making a difference and making our community as strong as it is today. And I look forward to the future and growth of the next 50 years. And with that, I think let me just hand it over to my colleague, Commissioner Steve Wantz, to say a few words. Thanks.
So good morning, everybody. What a nice crowd. On behalf of our colleagues who aren't with us today, and I gotta say, Commissioner Rothstein and I, we made out pretty well because two of our colleagues, Commissioner Frazier and Commissioner Weaver, are right now participating in the Special Olympics at Westminster High School. Just imagine how chilly they are right now at Westminster High School and how nice it is in here. Our senior population in Carroll, some of the most important people, the most knowledgeable folks, I say this all the time, you can't travel without talking to someone who hasn't been to one of our senior centers. How amazing are our senior centers? Folks from other jurisdictions come to our senior centers because of what we do. And as Commissioner Rothstein says, we do it better than anybody. In my experience in Annapolis with the Maryland Association of Counties, I talk to my colleagues, see what they do across the state. They got nothing on us. We do it better than anybody. So to our staff, to everybody that's been involved, Fran, for you starting this, congratulations. What a remarkable feat of being 50 years old, which in senior terms, that's pretty young, gotta tell you. Can you get into AARP at 50?
Yeah.
Okay, you can. All right, okay, all right. Okay, I stand corrected on that, okay? But again, thank you all so much for being here today. The fact that this room is filled says it all. It is just amazing. And to all of the staff over the years that have been involved to get us to where we are today, thank you, thank you, thank you. And to all of you, continue to enjoy these tremendous facilities and what our staff does. They're wonderful, and you all can attest to that. So keep up the good work, keep getting younger, and just have a good time. Enjoy life. Life is short. You can enjoy it because of what our folks do here in the county. Thank you all very much.
Next, Jennifer and Nan, representing Senator Cardin and Van Hollen's office.
Good morning, everybody. We are the federal delegation, and we represent Senator Van Hollen and Senator Cardin's office. And we are very, very, very honored to be here today. And Gina, we loved listening to the story of the history. Fran, my gosh, what a great beginning you had. And in 50 years, seeing the growth that the Senior Center has employed is magnificent. And we are just honored to be part of the ceremony and part of the celebration. And again, if there's anything our bosses can do, please let us know. And we do have a proclamation from the federal government saying, in recognizing the 50th anniversary, in recognition of the support that it provides to seniors, veterans, caregivers, and individuals with disabilities, with gratitude for its outstanding efforts to connect the residents of Carroll County with the services, programs, resources that they need, with appreciation for all it does to touch the lives of others. So I thank you. And I do have to say that Westminster is a second home to me. I was married into a man that grew up in Westminster, and I can honestly say what Commissioner Wendt said is there's no better place to be than Westminster. So thank you. Jessica, would you like to say a couple words? Or?
Good morning. My name is Jessica Cook. I'm from Senator Cardin's office. I just want to briefly say congratulations and thank you for 50 years of incredible service to Carroll County community. I know it is appreciated by so many people. So thank you and congratulations.
Thank you so much, Jessica and Nan. Next, I have Elaine May Stem. She is representing Secretary Owings. And Elaine is a member of the Maryland Veterans Commission and also an appointed member of our Veterans Advisory Council.
And don't mess with me. Well, good morning. Yes, I am a commissioner on the Maryland's Veterans Commission under Governor Hogan. And Secretary Owings was invited today, but he asked me to say a few words. And there is a commissioner on each of the military service organizations, and that's what we do when the governor or Secretary Owens cannot attend an event, we just go and say a few words for him, because they can't do them all. Today, we are here to celebrate 50 years of serving Carroll County, and it is growing fast day by day. Since 1972, the Carroll County government and its programs, services, activities, and facilities have been actively assisting local families. There are 5 senior citizen centers in this county. And yes, during COVID-19, they were closed because of the government guidelines. But what they did do when they were able to open some way, they served lunches. You call in, you put your order, you know, what you want, and then you go to the entrance, and then you pick it up, drive off. That was a great way of serving our community, and it worked. Anyone requiring aid and services should take the opportunity to contact the Department of Citizen Services, because the staff are trained to help those in need. This lady and her staff have been taking care of veterans. There are services officers who are pushing service claims through the system, and it's not easy, for veterans who have medical and mental issues, and that is very important to all of us. They are also reaching out to the homeless veteran and their families and to assist in any way they can. Secretary did want me to mention to you all that there is planning and it's work in progress to make a veterans home in Carroll County, and it's going to be in the Sykesville area. How long down the road that's going to happen, but that's... They are actively working on that, and it's doing well. It's all paperwork drill. I do want to mention our event on 15 May celebrating Carroll County veterans. It's going to be at the Farm Museum. There is flyers out there. Please pick them up to remind you at our Veterans Advisory Council table, which will be manned. Everybody should come out and enjoy. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Elaine. And then Dean Brewer, again representing State's Attorney Alan Culver.
Good morning. How's everyone? Good. Everyone got to test out to make sure they didn't have COVID, because you could smell that barbecue cooking out there on the cooker this morning. That was great. I'm representing Alan Culver here today. I'm the chief investigator in the Carroll County State's Attorney's Office. I'll also be presenting a couple of the classes for scams and that type of information to help keep you keep your money in your pocket so that you don't lose it to the scammers that are out there. So I just want to let you know that the Carroll County State's Attorney's Office has made it a priority, especially in the past 7 years, to serve the vulnerable population by making sure that we go after those individuals that are scamming individuals, abuse and neglect of the vulnerable adult population in the nursing homes, assisted living, and the developmentally disabled group homes. This is a growing problem. It's where child abuse was 40 years ago. So we aggressively prosecute those individuals that want to harm our vulnerable adult population out there. The other thing is the amount of money that is stolen through scams from our vulnerable population is unbelievable. It's not unusual to see where someone has lost as much as $100,000 here in Carroll County. So just, you know, again, we want to thank Gina and the crew here for everything they do. They have us and they allow us to come out to present to the senior centers. So we give presentations out there on scams and how to hold on to your money. So anytime or any questions that you may have, you can catch me today in the classroom at 11 and 12. So I want to thank you all and glad you're able to make it out here for this 50 years. Thanks so much.
Thank you so much, Dean. And then Jim McCarron, the chair of our Commission on Aging and Disabilities.
Good morning, everyone, and what a great crowd we have on this chilly spring morning. At least I think it's spring. But we'll hold out the good thought. You know, I can't say how much I appreciate my involvement with the Commission on Aging. I've been involved with the Commission now for several years, formerly as mayor of Tawnytown, and then since my untimely retirement, I have been serving as the chairman of the commission, and the members of our board, the members of our staff, Celine and Gina and the rest, are incredible in their dedication to the needs of their charges, the seniors, the disabled, and the veterans. And it's a team like this that we have in place that underscores the success the commissioners brought up this morning. We should all be proud to be part of this county and part of this system of care for those who are disabled, those who are elderly, and those who are served our country as veterans. 50 years is a long time. It's not as long as it used to be. You know, I notice the older I get, the less it seems to be. But, you know, when I think back what I was doing in 1972, it certainly wasn't, I didn't have any thoughts about being as a chairman of the Commission of Aging in Carroll County. But time goes by and the events that transpire in our lives fill us with great memories and great opportunities for the future. I look forward to continuing to serve everyone in this capacity for a number of years to come. And I want to thank you very much for coming today. I look forward to the festivities. I'll be here all day, and I look forward to meeting you. Come stop by our table and chat. If you have any questions, I'll be happy to talk to you. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Jim. And Celine Steckel, our Director of Department of Citizen Services.
All right. Thank you very much. I think that ringtone might have been one of the musical selections that we have for our line dancing. That was just a preview. Now, I wanted to welcome you and thank you all for coming to celebrate with us. Today is a great event, a great day. And I'm excited to be joined this morning, as Gina said, by our friends from AARP, as we recognize our past 50 years of commitment to serving older adults. Through the years, we have expanded our reach to include people with disabilities, veterans, and those who care for them. Throughout the past 50 years, we have become the cornerstone of aging and disability services and the point of contact for people in the Carroll County community. Our partnerships continue to develop as we recognize that it takes a village and lots of communication and coordinated efforts to make sure that we're able to give people the access to services that they need. We mark our 50th anniversary today with a continued commitment to aging timelessly in Carroll County by making application and being accepted into AARP's age-friendly community network. Through the work and research and the recommendation of our Carroll Together Optimal Living Subcommittee of our Commission on Aging and Disabilities, the AARP age-friendly designation was recognized as a priority for Carroll County and where we wanted to head. With the support of our Board of Carroll County Commissioners, we also made that application, and that is why they are here with us today with AARP. The Age-Friendly Community Initiative will be a 5-year plus initiative that will positively impact aging in Carroll County for years to come. This will happen by broadening our partnerships, reaching out and inviting our community at large, and especially people that may have, and businesses, entities that we may have not never thought about bringing in to look at how we help people age better in Carroll County. We're trying to think outside of the box when we start this and launch this initiative. So we invite you all to be part of this with us today. We also want to ensure that Carroll County is a place where we can age timelessly. So it's my pleasure to introduce and invite to the podium Hank Greenberg, who is the State Director, as Gina said, of AARP, Jennifer Holtz, our Associate State Director of Outreach, and Nancy Carr, who will come, I believe, in a minute after the first piece.
Thank you so much. I am Hank Greenberg, not the baseball player. This is a room in which people will remember who that was, I suspect, right? And I know that, Commissioner, you are 100% right. You asked the question, can you be a ARP member at what age? It's 50. Well, we're here to tell you it's so true that we have for you, Gina, come on up, your own Carroll County 50th anniversary ARP membership card. With that underway, and what a beautiful facility this is, what a great crowd you have today. Thank you all very much for being with us and inviting us to be a part of this. And as you just heard, one of the great things you're doing to start your next 50 years is to become a part of the AARP World Health Organization Age-Friendly Community Network. And so what that means is we're now almost 700 communities across the country that are a part of this. And you'll find out more information, not only from the residents here, but also across the country. Compare notes. Who's tried something that you might want to try, or you may have an idea someone else wants to try. And you know, Commissioner Rothstein, you mentioned earlier listening, that's what leadership is all about. And that is really part one of listening, is when you get to be a member, you become, the first step you do is you listen to your constituents. You listen to the county. What is it that you really need? What's important to you? You then put together in the second year a plan. And then in the years after, you implement the plan. So it's a structure of some sort. And we applaud the commissioners for deciding that they want to go ahead with this. The next 50 years is going to be even better than the first 50. So let me, with that, turn it to Jen Holtz, who is our Associate State Director for Outreach and Community, and she'll be working very closely with the folks here in Carroll County. Jen?
Thank you, Hank. So many reasons to celebrate today. Happy anniversary. This is amazing. And the turnout is just unbelievable. This is actually my first in-person event since COVID, and I cannot think of a better way to celebrate this day. So thank you for having us today. With regards to your entrance into the AARP Network of Age-Friendly Communities, this is truly an honor to present this certificate to you. The Network of Age-Friendly Communities means that you've made a commitment to making sure that Carroll County is more livable for people of all ages. And we say it over and over again, what's good for an 80-year-old is good for an 8-year-old, right? So thank you for your commitment to that. This is a new way of doing business that requires collaboration among agencies and community members and organizations so that everyone is working together to make Carroll County more livable. So congratulations to you. And I hereby present you with the certification ticket. It says, Carroll County, Maryland has committed to becoming more age-friendly under the criteria established by AARP and has been accepted as a member of the AARP Network of Age-Friendly States and Communities. Congratulations. It's signed by our CAO, Nancy Lamont.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Photos.
One in, Hank. Yeah,
okay,
you should be
okay,
here
okay.
For this one. That's important.
They should be in the photo.
That's right. Thank you very much. Okay. All right. So now we've let you know about that exciting initiative that we're moving forward on. Enjoy your time, and thank you all for celebrating with us today.